अभी कर दो, लिंक में दूंगी
वो कैमरा खुल कर नहीं।
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, आवर गेस्ट फॉर टुडे इज आवर वेरी ओन फैकल्टी मेंबर डॉक्टर राधा लूज मैन एक्सपर्टाइजेस इन द एरिया ऑफ मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट स्पेशलाइज्ड इंक्लूड सर्विसेज मैनेजमेंट कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर एंड मार्केटिंग फंडामेंटल्स She has 12 years of academic experience and 6 years of corporate experience. Ma'am has published several papers in Scopus and UGC listed journals. She has looked after the placements in our institute for 4.5 years. She has contributed in the permanent affiliation of the institute as well as in the 2F and 12B UGC approval. Ma'am is currently heading the Alumni Relation Committee and Management Development Committee. She is also a core member of IQAC team. Now I kindly request Director Sir to welcome our guest. Now I kindly request Ma'am to take over the session.
Ma'am, you want to start na PPT? Adha ma'am, you want to start PPT?
Yes.
Thank you, Rajul, for that introduction. And thank you, Vincent, sir. Thanks so much, Varun. So, good afternoon, students. First of all, I would like to thank sir for giving me this opportunity to talk about the internal quality assurance committee that we have. So you can make a note of what we are going to have in the presentation and how all of us can contribute in making what and where we are. So together we are Nevillians, Nevillvanians. So I'm going to take you through a presentation on what the institute, the ideology of the institute, what does the modern education society believes in, and I'll be taking you through how IQAC takes into consideration the student's role and how does the IQAC plans when it is student support programs. So we'll begin in some time. Till then you can make sure that you have pen and paper with you. Thank you. Can we start? Anybody who knows, we just share IQAC. IQAC is internal quality assurance cell. So why do we have it? First of all, what am I going to tell you and how and what does the society believe in? So if you see on my left hand side, you can see a board where modern education society is written, and there's a list of institutions from the time we started the first institution till the end. So we are also one of that. Just to tell you more about when did we start, we've already told you that we began in 1991. So I'm going to tell you about more about what does the IQAC cell does, what is my role, how and what would be your role to contribute towards what we have planned. So slowly we will be moving ahead with the kind of activities which are specifically meant for the students. So let's talk about who are the core team members. So yesterday, the voice is breaking. Can you hear me? I'll use the mic or I'll not use the mic. Don't use.
Thank you. So yesterday, the madam, our Dr. Anuradha ma'am, spoke on self-awareness. She is the one who is heading the IQAC committee. So she is the IQAC coordinator. The director is automatically the in-charge of the institute and part of every committee. So under the IQAC, just to explain you better, IQAC takes care of internal quality of the institute. Now, what and how is that we manage? So there are 26 committees under the IQAC cell. And these 26 committees are decided and finalized on the basis of areas in which fronts the institute would like to take ahead the work that has been assigned. So you might be noticing, or you will henceforward, when we move ahead, you will notice that there is a research committee, which is relevant to the teachers as well as students. There's admin committee. There are a lot of committees where student requirement and involvement is required. So the IQAC takes care of a lot of, I would say, functions. But how is IQAC contributing towards student-related functions, and how can student contribute in the IQAC is what we are going to discuss. So the committee, or I would say this cell, is headed by Dr. Anuradha. There are three more members in the team. So Professor Vinod, the CEO, that is the examination officer. Sir has already briefed you about exams. So Professor Vinod, then we have Dr. Karuna Jadhav, and the fourth name that you could see is one of the members, the one who is interacting with you. So that's me. So these four people are part of the IQAC core team. Let's move it. Then can you change the slide? So what does the IQAC committee, or what does the IQAC team believes in? And how is the institute, the overall, I would say, belief or the ideology on which we function? So the society believes that we are an institution which is completely cosmopolitan, democratic, and we are in the education service. So education comes as priority number one, unlike other institutions which are purely business driven. So here the owners are not functioning as if they are, you know, making profit out of this particular trust. So they drive the objective of this particular society is purely devotion towards education. So that's the principle on which the modern education society believes in. So that's point number one, which is the uniqueness of this society, where the society stands tall with this ideology is what we function and move ahead. And that is what I wanted to highlight. This is our uniqueness as well. So when it comes to education, that's our first priority rather than commercial interest, unlike those who take education as if it's their business. So that's point number one. When we look at what is the institution, what have we achieved so far? So we are NAC accredited. We are 2F and 12B. These are the acts from UGC. So we are approved by the UGC for research. And we are permanently affiliated to Savitribai Phule Pune University. Apart from that, we've got MBA and PhD in management. So there are a lot of things that I wanted to mention. So just to highlight few achievements over a period of years. So we are a 9-decade-old educational society. So some of the institutions might have completed platinum jubilee, golden jubilee, silver jubilee, even we have completed. So we are now 30-year-old in management education. So we started in 1991, we've already completed 30 years. So we are also one of the oldest institutions in management education. Ma'am, can you move ahead? So let's now come to specifically out of what everything that IQAC does and how and what is we are going to discuss today. So we will be discussing specifically everything that is student related. So this presentation will cover the student collaboration, coordination, participation, and how we will be evaluating it. So let's look at the first point. Where we're looking at how do we relate with the students and how whatever is mentioned on this slide is related and relevant to you. When I talk about academic calendar, so academic calendar is a prior planning or a schedule which explains how the lectures will be conducted, what will be the timetable, how the curriculum will move ahead, when are we going to finish the syllabus, as well as it covers concurrent evaluations. So you can note that if you want. So it covers how, which faculty will be planning their concurrent evaluation, and at the end of it, the CO and PO mapping. So all that is covered under academic calendar. So when academic calendar is made, it takes care of the academic year. For you, there are two academic years. This year, that is your first year, and one more year after that. So in the academic calendar, there'll be timetable, there'll be COPO mapping, there'll be a detailed schedule of CCEs. CCEs, concurrent evaluation planned by the faculty. Next document, inclusion of perspective. So how do we do this? So we have a system where we take feedback from the employers, from the students, from the stakeholders like parents, even from the faculty members who are involved in teaching. So there is a 360 degree feedback mechanism which helps us to understand where we are lacking. So how and what does it cover? So it helps us with a line, or I would say number of pointers where we need to improve. So that's where we have put a system in place where we capture the feedback and we work on it. So henceforth, whenever there is an event and you have been circulated a Google form, please give correct feedback. Just don't tick the blocks by highlighting that it was very good. Give genuine feedback. It will be helpful for us to improve. Let us move ahead. Let's look at the third one, add-on certificate programs. So what are add-on certificate programs? Sir was mentioning day before yesterday that we also give over and above the syllabus. How many subjects do we have right now in the syllabus? We've already discussed this. 12. So 6 core subjects, which are university evaluation as well as institute evaluations, which means 3 credit subjects, 3 university level subjects, and 3 from the institute level. Apart from that, we offer add-on certificate programs in the area of finance, marketing, business analytics, Excel, and a lot of as per the requirement of the industry. So some of them which we've already offered and we've given certification are entrepreneurship development, digital marketing, advanced Excel, and many more, even digital banking. So how does it add value? Can anybody tell me? How is that going to add value? This is apart from what is mentioned in the curriculum. So it adds value in terms of what is the distinctiveness when you are compared with others who are applying for interviews. So you become more and more relevant in that field. So that's the advantage of enrolling for a certificate program. Do you want to ask something here? I will be moving ahead. Ma'am, can you move to the next slide? So what is that we do? So that all that we do is student-centric. So point number one, caliber of faculty. Now, how do we put this in place? So point number one, out of 12 faculties, 8 are PhDs. 4 have enrolled or are in the process of enrolling for PhD. So 65%, more than that, of our faculty have completed their PhD degree. They're also in the process of applying for various projects, engaged in industry lecturing, participating in FDP programs, and making sure that they give you what is relevant and required in the industry. Let's look at the second one, diversity of faculty. So there are people who've got 25 years of experience, there are people who have 15 and 20 years of experience, and there are people who are very young faculty as well. So we have a mix which gives you an overall outlook of how the industry functions. People with industry background, those who have worked in the industry for about 10 years and 20 years. So there is a right mix. When we look at passing percentage, what does that mean? Passing percentage is one of the way how we will evaluate where we stand. Now, who's passing percentage and why are we discussing it here? Your passing percentage. So your grades, your marking system, your scores matter to us. How do they matter? We are also being evaluated on the result analysis of how much that has been achieved after teaching you the subject. So how many people pass, the passing or the attainment level, that matters to us. So how many people have scored above distinction? How many people have just passed? So we'll look at those kind of analysis. It helps us to look at the numbers and where we need to improve. So your scoring, your evaluations and your university results are actually being worked at, they are being looked at critically, and we also identify where do we need to improve. Let's look at the next one, 50% marks for surveys. So there have been a system in place which captures the feedback, and which is you just do not control or edit the survey. So there is a survey which covers or which is directly reported to the accreditation body. You do not change the scores, or it is directly being referred by the NAC committee. So those 50% weightage is for the student survey, and it is directly getting reported to the accreditation body. So that keeps the student interest as the prime focus. When we look at ICT tools, what are ICT tools? For example, if we shift from this mode to online mode, how are we going to connect? Zoom, Google Classroom, or there could be any other method in which we could communicate. So when we connect through that method, we'll have recorded lectures, we'll have study material being posted to you, we'll have an arrangement where pre-recorded lectures could be actually made available to you. And even the concurrent evaluations be taken in the online mode. So ICT tools will help us to do that better. How ICT tools and which ICT tools? So we've got e-resources, we've got physical books in the library, we've got 60 computers, so our infrastructure is adequate. So that is what I want to highlight. Apart from that, we also conduct live sessions for every subject. So this session is where people can interact. And apart from that, we also have Google Classroom where notes are being posted. We also make sure that whatever is going or whatever is being given to you is actually relevant with what is required by the industry. Do you want to ask anything here? I'll be moving ahead. Maybe you can ask your questions at the end. Ma'am, next slide, please. So there are two ways of doing this. One is social sensitizing on various topics. Another one is professional sensitizing. So how do we do that? For example, input, then there is a process which is ongoing, and output. So how do we measure the output of this institute? Placements, upgradation of students after enrolling and after leaving the course. Many of them, how many students took up higher education after this? So that is one way of assessing what students do after this course. How many went into their family business, or how many started their own startup? So those are the ways in which we check or we study the progression. So that's the output. Now, what is the input? How do we know what kind of input has come to us? So you're going to give some psychometric test, some aptitude test. There will be some measuring mechanism in place. What is the mechanism going to help us with? It's going to help us with which are the areas of improvement. And accordingly, whatever interventions will be required, the necessary that is required, or necessary actions or interventions that are required, will be undertaken. Let's look at social sensitizing. Now, what is social sensitizing? Which means you not even just get a degree after 2 years, but you also have a very, very broad outlook. You become good individuals. You become individuals who have got a very strong value system, a very good character. So based on these events, we try and highlight or we try and sensitize you all on contributing to these activities. So it's not just producing a student academically, but also making sure that you become responsible citizens. So what are the kind of activities? So we've already organized blood donation. We are associated with Red Cross Society. I'm sure many of you might be knowing this name. Currently, we've got NSS approval, which we already have informed you all. So NSS unit will be set up where students can contribute depending on their interest level. Next is Swachh Bharat. So we've already done some events, some campaigns under Swachh Bharat, I would say, activity. Then AIDS awareness, there are guest lectures, there are medical practitioners who highlight or who talk about how people need to be made aware of the kind of illnesses and what are the drawbacks of getting, of not becoming aware. So all these sensitizing programs help us to make sure that we know what is around us and make the student more responsible citizen. So these are the kind of programs which we have already done. We will be continuing to do this. Apart from that, we've got collaborative activities. Now, what is a collaborative activities? Where teachers and students work together. So how is a teacher and a student going to work together? So there is a ROAR team and there is a MEET team. So what are these teams going to do? For example, 2 years ago, your previous batches have organized inter-level events. So talking about what kind of collaboration you could come up with. In fact, even if you move to the online mode, think about collaborative activities where you would work together with the teachers. For example, there are examples which I share with you. There are faculties, students together write research papers. That's also a collaborative activity. So there could be many more. Here we are still working on this area. This can become a best practice. UGC research papers and journals. These are two ways in which we've already started engaging with these students. Apart from this, there are many things I have not written, like the student with these students. Apart from this, there are many things I have not written, like the student participating or having specific sessions. Very, very specific, I would say, requirements like the behavior, the COVID-appropriate behavior. Don't you think we can have a guest lecture on such kind of topic? A lot of people do not adhere to whatever norms or whatever has been dictated by the government. So you can have a guest lecture on that. So that's also a suggestion which would be welcome. So students are encouraged to give suggestions on whichever kind of activities they think would be appropriate for them. Ma'am, next slide. What is that we do so that the learning and teaching process is enabled? So we take care of infrastructure management and we make sure that there are assigned budgets, there is provision to take care of infrastructural facilities as well as academic facilities. Now, what is the academic facility? Academic facility where library has enough books, adequate number of books, computer lab has enough number of computers, your seating arrangement, you've got enough of classrooms, the LCD, projector, seminar hall, and maintaining and upkeep of all these infrastructural facilities is taken care so that the teaching and learning process is smooth. Next talks about library e-resources. So these e-resources will help you with databases or research papers or the latest content that is available on these e-resources. So you can contact the library and get access to these e-resources. You can learn more about what is there that is being shared on these e-resources. Let's look at computer lab being equipped with adequate infrastructure. In fact, we are also moving ahead with replacing the existing computers. So that is in the plan. So this is how we're making the infrastructure more than adequate so that teaching learning is highly enabled. Apart from that, we've also have solar, then rainwater harvesting, green audit, fire audit, which is mandatory, of course, it is as well as compliance driven, and it enables the overall facilitating the entire capacity to deliver the right kind of infrastructure that needs to be made available. Ma'am, next slide. When we look at student-centric programs, what is that we have? So when we look at the first one, we've already shared this with all of you. There are scholarship schemes which are available. So that's one of the provision where people can look forward to where they can apply for such kind of schemes. Apart from that, we have capability enhancement programs. Now this is taken care of. Most of the activities that I'll be highlighting here are faculty driven or the placement cell driven. So this is specifically when we look at career planning, when we look at career as a bigger picture. So what are the kind of activities that we engage in? So point number one takes care of mentor-mentee concept. So there are about 120, assuming that there are more number of students, So 12 faculty, so roughly every faculty gets 10 to 11 students in his team, to which every faculty is individually going to attend and connect with these students so that they could understand the student requirements. So that makes easy the entire process of connecting and engaging with these students. So every faculty is actually given a team of 10 to 11 students who then engage better. When you look at career counseling, values and ethics, business etiquettes and personality development, which is again under the umbrella of placement activities. So we have a full-time placement officer who will be engaging and conducting these kind of activities which will help you in career advancement. So apart from this, there are many other things that are conducted by the placement itself. Right now, what is more important here is there is social sensitizing as well as there is career driven plan. So what is that is required? For example, I'll just give few examples. There is a specific interview for which the students undergo some kind of training and mentoring from the placement officer as well as from the faculty members, because they are the subject matter experts in that area. So whatever the JD, whatever the requirement specifies, accordingly the faculty engages with those students so that they could crack the interview. So such kind of initiatives are again faculty and the placement cell together, they drive such kind of initiatives. Apart from that, there are MCQs, there are I would say set of questions that could be given to you so that you prepare well. So when it comes to technical knowledge, when it comes to soft skills, everything as a package could be delivered the best to the student so that the student actually matches the expectations of the industry. When we look at, apart from that, what is that we do? So we encourage students to take up higher education or apply for MPSC, UPSC exams. Startups, we have an ED cell, dedicated ED cell, which takes care of a lot of activities where how you could conceptualize on an idea and how you could make sure that the idea is taken to the next level. So that's also being done through that, through the ED cell. Apart from that, CSR initiatives, so we've already tied up with two organizations which are into CSR initiative. Even we would like to collaborate with them so that our students contribute towards the society, and we do our bit. So we've already in talks with Mahir organization, which takes care of children as well as destitute women. So that Mahir is one of the organizations where we are planning to go ahead with the MOU. The second organization is GTT. So they are into CSR activity where they train people and make them the opportunities that are available in the industry so that those people could be placed. So we are tied up with GTT as well. Apart from that, NSS is one way that we have found out where we could do our part towards the society. We are moving ahead with alumni association registration, which means that we will be registering our alumni association, which will even be more beneficial for our students, because we've got a, I would say, a huge database of alumni where we can connect and have better opportunities. So we've decided, as part of the policy, we've decided to form SIG. So what is SIG? SIG is special interest groups. So for example, there are people, there are 15, 20 people who are specializing in BA, about 30, 40 people specializing in finance. So accordingly, alumni who are working in those areas could come and contribute and talk to, give the right kind of study material or the required knowledge that is accepted in the industry. So that's the objective which we are trying to chase once we register our alumni association. Next slide, please. So apart from that, what is that the faculty undertakes? So the faculty is encouraged to attend faculty development programs, FDPs, workshops, seminars, and conferences so that they gain a lot of exposure and they could deliver better in the overall teaching learning process. As I shared, there are 65% of the faculty members who are PhDs, and we have an excellent mix of faculty who have come with a lot of industry experience, and this would help to deliver the right kind of education or the kind of skills that would be required by the corporate. Apart from that, there is the ideology, the principle with which the society has been formed, under which we are operating. For them, stakeholders' benefit comes first and not the profit. So that's our uniqueness, on which we are very proud to say that we are different and unique from what all others are there in the market. So this is where all of us can really be very proud of, that you're in the right kind of institution. Apart from this, we've also planned that we will be moving ahead in the few months to come, that we will be getting ISO certified. So we've already started the process. 21001 is the series which is applicable to the education sector. So once we are ISO certified, this is going to further add a lot of value to the processes. Which processes? Admin processes, admission processes, and all the back-end processes, where that will definitely benefit for the students who will enroll after this. Ma'am, next slide, please. So what are we looking forward to, or what is the uniqueness? What is that we are offering, which is really standing out as compared to the competitors? So when I look at the first point, collaborative learning. So right now we are doing this by extreme, I would say, efforts, right from the faculty as well as students. Even the students are very happy to connect with us and get into collaborative learning. So right now it is happening in the format of research, I would say, papers. We would like to take this to the next level by making sure that students also participate in the research projects. So this is where we're looking forward to connect with the students and the faculties together, driving the collaborative learning. This is where we would like to highlight this as a unique practice. Apart from that, alumni meet is our uniqueness. What is alumni meet, and why is, and how is that beneficial for us? So as I said, alumni network. So we've had 30 years in existence. So we would like to connect with those alumni, and they are the ones who will share what is required in the industry. And hence, alumni registration and alumni special interest groups. So we would like to highlight these as our unique practices. Apart from that, international conferences. We've got national, international workshops, state-level conferences, state-level workshops. What is that for? What is the intention of having that? So intention is exposure. So the students get exposed to different cultures, gets to interact with a lot of people who are coming from different countries. Right now, at this moment, there are restrictions, but we have done it for years. So this is a continuous practice and one of our best practices. If it's not happening offline, we will be having it online. Industrial visits, right now limited, but we've done this every year. So there have been regular visits to the industry. Right now, we plan that we will be having virtual industrial visits. So for which we've also worked on the permissions from the industry to go ahead and enroll for virtual industrial visits. So whether it is offline or online, industrial visits will be also happening. And the last one, MOUs for placements and CSR. So MOUs, we're talking about placement, I would say officer have already discussed with you, Fuel, Naukri.com and other organizations where we've already had the MOU signed. So that they evaluate our students, they would assess our students and give us the required reports so that we know which are the areas on which we would like to work. Apart from that, CSR. So this is one of the areas where we are contributing right now and we're doing well here. What is coming up next? What is that we are looking forward to, or where is that we need to work so that we move one level ahead? So one is alumni registration. Second is ISO certification. Third is projects, research projects, faculty and the students together. So these are the three areas right now we are focusing our attention and trying to build on that. So I think that is all that I had. I would like to thank all of you all for your patient listening. The IQAC coordinator is here. So if you have any questions, ma'am is also here. The other faculty members are also there. They can also try and answer your questions if there are any questions. If there are no questions, then we will be stopping here. Thank you very much. something? या तो सब कुछ समझा या कुछ नहीं समझा. समझा? अच्छा क्या समझा? Thank you so much. What's your name?
Saurabh.
Thank you so much, Saurabh. That really shows that you are very attentive. Uske liye ya mere liye? Aapke liye. Very attentive. Yes.
Is it feasible to do PhD while post degree?
No. Then after degree.
Yes.
Yes. We are affiliated with Savitribai Phule University, so then it's PET 1 and PET 2. Until you put an infill or a set, then you directly move ahead to the interview round. So after your master's, if you're interested for PhD, we are also a PhD center.
But for that, they need to do now net.
Haan, they make
a
phone
call. Now you need to be a bit troublesome.
Now it's in one condition they are going to apply from the next year. Before that you have to be clear your net and set exam to be useful for your education.
Students get a chance to work in CSR. What a valid question. Yes. We would want you to volunteer and work with us. So, it is not, I mean, we don't want to tell people to, you know, join hands with us and work with us. If you think that you want to contribute, it is coming by will, it should be voluntary. So, I've given you the broad areas on which you and we can join hands. So, we are not Neville until unless you join hands with us. So, together we are Neville. Is there anything else that you would like to ask?
I'm here, I'd like to add up something.
Yes, ma'am.
I am taking the students where they are doing counseling for the students who actually don't know where they need to go after their graduation or after their work. Like we have certain videos also, the initial video had came up. After that, we have been going for the specialization type of people. Like if you are opting to offer, what are the schemes available? If you are going a hard science, what are the schemes available? So if you want to be a part of the same, you can contact SOPA. Because we have been coming up with another series of that initiative is in chicken safety called as well. You can find it on our social media.
Thank you, ma'am. There is one more thing that I missed out. So we've also taken initiative to tie up with Oxford University so that they could give you the programs. It is voluntary again. If you wish to enroll, only then you could show your interest and enroll for those courses. So we have enrolled with Oxford University as well. This came to my mind when ma'am was talking about the other thing.
They all are paid courses.
They all are paid courses, yes.
You will be getting 20% discount on that particular courses. The courses are specifically associated with financial watching, IFRS, then cybersecurity, business assets. So we will be discussing the course part of the having the session initially one-to-one, then from the Oxford University, you will be having a webinar from them. So if you are having any questions, you want to enroll for the course, we will be planning a webinar, maybe in the middle of January. So then if you it's a complete online platform, right? You will be getting 20% discount because you are doing the
you would like to ask? Okay. So just to sum up, IQAC is more than just student support program or student support initiatives. This is one of the things that where IQAC has got student-centric initiatives. So it's more than that. But because we're talking to students and how would we seek your participation and how would we join hands together so that we take this ahead. That's the reason this particular presentation. So I'm sure you have a broad ideas on how we could take this ahead. So whoever is interested in whichever activities can contact us, the names given, contact ma'am or any faculty, and then we can take that forward. So thank you so much, all of you, for your patient listening. We will be stopping here. Ma'am, you want to say something? Broadly, I've told them that the IQAC take care. Please come if you would like to. So we will be talking about the kind of committees that we have. We will be sharing that with you, either online or maybe tomorrow.
Every day,
the names of the committees.
So that they'll also participate in the session.
Ma'am, I already briefed you on the number of committees we have, about 23 committees I have already mentioned earlier. So students can join the committees. There are some places the students can't join, except on the examination committee, you can't be in that committee. You cannot be in the purchase committee, right? So somewhere the students are barred from coming in, but there are many committees where the students should come in because you're a part of us, okay? You're also the stakeholders, so you're a part of us, you should know how this institute functions. So we'll appreciate students joining these committees. So soon the list of mentees and mentors will be put up, maybe in a day or two. So you will get your mentees as well as your mentors. And after that, we'll be putting up the list of committees. It is there on the website. So whichever you would like to join, you can talk to your mentors accordingly, and then you can join that, right? So if we need the inputs from the students, this is a student-driven institute, so we have to see the quality has to go. We have to think about the quality. So it is you who make the quality. Okay, if you stand with us, the quality will improve better. Of course, it is a we are trying to excel. And if you see the IIMs, so I told you earlier also, the IIMs, the students are so polished. So we want you to be the same. Be with us. Wherever you think that you can give your inputs, please give. Okay. Wherever you think that you need to upgrade your skills, please give. Accordingly, we all will be there to help you. There is nothing that we will say that don't do this, do that. Okay. If you think that you are going beyond also, nothing will happen with your marks. Your marks will remain the same whatever you give. Right. So see that. You be with us and improve this institute to grow better. If they improve better, you will also grow. Okay?
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Just one last input. We would like to see the next evaluation of the NAC committee will be happening in 2023. And that is the time when you will be there with us. So what you have done and how you contributed in the entire process is going to add value to you as well as to the institute. So we are going to feel great if we say that I come from Neville and Neville is so-and-so. So together, as I said, we make Neville, not just the teachers and not just the students. So together we make Neville, and any kind of assessment is just a way to measure that where is that we need to improve. So quality principle says anything that could be measured could be improved. So your assessment, your psychometric testing, your other evaluations are the ways of measuring where you stand right now. And what is that you're going to add, and what is that gets into the process? And finally, in the output, how is that you've been able to achieve that? So the entire exercise of all your assessments, your CCs, your university results, your all other kind of tests that you are participating in are going to add value to the output that we are going to achieve. With this, I'll be stopping here. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Radha ma'am, Anuradha ma'am, and Sriti ma'am for guiding us. Our next speaker today is Vikas Dole sir. Sir is currently head of our of department of our institute. He has 2 years of experience in corporate world. Sir joined the institute 16 years ago in 2006 and has been working with the institute since then. He teaches subjects like marketing research, rural marketing, consumer behavior, as well as sales and distribution. Sir is also involved in research and takes corporate consultancy work. I request Sir to kindly take the session.
Just going to make announcement. कनेक्टेड है क्या?
हाँ है ना सर, ये अपन कनेक्टेड है, अपन कनेक्टेड है.
एमिल वाडिया
का जानते हो लोग वही तो एमिल वाडिया हाँ फर्स्ट
मैं फॉलो करती हूँ सर.
हाँ करता हूँ मैडम की नहीं नहीं ना मूल की साड़े बिकती थे और मालूम है मूल की बेगी साड़े बिकना रही थी है आपने मुझे
दी सेटेड आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू यूज लेंथी प्रेजेंटेशन आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू यूज सम डिफरेंट इनपुट
नहीं बेगी मालूम है मूल की पिछले बिकती थे और
मैं है साइट से लेता
हूँ. नेविल वाडिया तक पूर्ण नेविल वाडिया इंस्टिट्यूट ऑफ हाँ आता है खाल
पेज
पेज क्लिक नहीं जाते हाँ वीडियो मे काय मी बिलकुल प्रिपेअर नाही मॅडम फर्स्ट काय अनाउन्समेंट केली हेच आहे पंधरा पेक्षा
हे द्या मला फक्त खालची केबल हे वाली प्रोजेक्टरची
एकच मिनिट
Thank you. नाही ते तिथं थोडस लूज आहे सर त्याचं कनेक्शन
ह्याला काहीतरी काल केलं सर
लागेल तर ना ते स्टुडंट हे तरी सर प्रोजेक्ट कनेक्ट होत नाही स्पीकर भी लगेगा स्पीकर का पिन किधर है इधर एक लगाया मैंने उसको ये इनपुट ये वाला लगाना पड़ेगा ना उधर
By the time, like, I was going to do certain basic announcements, so, but as the introduction was there, by the time they organized, I just wanted to tell that, how many students are present, Akshay, roll number one, well, anyone is there, quite a few, list of mentees has been prepared by Dr. Karuna Gadha Madam, and 1 to 12 comes like under my guidance, 1 to 12, not 1 to 12, they have made some random, Akshay Bode, Jatho Mohini, Shinde, Sushrut, Sanke, Shruti, Pranali, Alekar Biskuit, Aishwarya, Sanjay, Rahul, Lengre, Doras, Saurabh, and Nikhil Bhatt, they are my name. As Madam was discussing about one of the project, Kartavya, so last year, these are the names.
Sir, we are going to display that video or the
first video. Madam was discussing about an initiative which was taken by your seniors under the name Kartavya, and this is a video which has been made by them. Please.
दो मिनट है मैम जस्ट
स्टिल बन गया
दोन माझं सेमच आहे ना मोठा बरोबर चालेल तेच माझं डोक्यात पहिल्यापासून थोडा पुढे पाठीमध्ये होईल
Thank you. and my current setup says like today's youth is to have education. So they need a proper guidance by which they can follow their passion and make the right career by choosing the right career path. So suppose, let's take an example. For which a student makes a better or dangerous which is a fit. So likewise, for our living, we need a food which is ours. Likewise, the young man needs a helping hand who can share their experiences with them and let it be their siblings, their seniors, teachers, and even the experienced professionals. So, this is we are providing you for the young minds by small initiatives called as a self-employer that is duty to do it. So, take passion with us. So, talking about the self-employer, Vedant will take you on this. Over to you, Vedant.
Hello everyone. Warm welcome to all. I am Vedant Reddy, mechanical engineer by education, and now a student of Navy Pavilion Institute of Management Studies and Research. So, guys, the state that you are in now, I have also gone to the state. But when I post passed out my time, there was literally no proper guidance as to which career path to choose, which ultimately confused me which career path to go on. At first, I opted to go for medical, but as time passed by, I decided to go for engineering, and then I landed up with technical engineering. And I'm thankful that you all also went to the same. So here we are, the students of Navy Pavilion Institute of Management Studies and Research, bringing a form for medical career. Yes, that's a way of duty to do it. What would you like to say? That is Vidya, Vidya Visheshana. Knowledge is only skill, which is necessary by sharing. We as a part of society need to pay back to the society. While a student, it is our core duty to share our experience and share our journey through the presentation. So here we are with our platform for the startup, which will provide guidance program, seminars, training, one-to-one marketing, and beyond. And that would be of course. So come and join our platform for the startup. Besides a beautiful and successful career for my life. Thank you. I stay tuned for further knowledge. Over to you, Vidya.
That's why you're not able to come up with the subsequent series of it. Right. So you're gonna obviously come up with commerce, finance, HR, the science. So those students who are from different backgrounds, right? Specifically those who have done their engineering, right? They can just came up, they can tell people that what are the different avenues, what are the different options available. So these this is the first initial part of the video only. And afterwards, obviously, we're gonna come up with so many things. And the last video, obviously, will be commenced by the faculties of Navy. Right? So I hope you all like it. So these sort of initiatives are expected by you, something unique, something different, where you know you can utilize your skill sets, where you know you can come up with your things, with your initiatives. So you people, you know, you all have to come to us, whatever are in your mind, with whatever your expectations are. You want certain type of you know, workshops, webinars, and different sort of things. If you want to perform something, right, if you have certain ideas, so we are all approachable. If you have any sort of such ideas, if you want to join the team in any of the way, you people can approach us and we'll be coming up with such sort of things. Obviously, this will be an added advantage to your personality as well as to your CV. So this is what basically employers are looking for, apart from your basic course, what you're going to pursue, right? So come up with your distinctive ideas, your thoughts, right? Thank you.
Whatever little I have to speak for the introduction. Okay, and whatever little I am going to speak is I'm learning from my learned faculty, so credit goes to them. I'm learning a lot of things from them. So as the intro is given, I am not really prepared, but I would like to use a line, a few suggestions. So can you write down in your diary? Can you please write down your diary that what is your routine activities? What you generally do in a typical day, how you spend your day. Please write down 2, 3, or 4 points, whatever activities which comes to your mind, which you feel are important, please write down in your diary.
नहीं पड़ेगी
I'm not really keen about what you have written. It's about you, it's about yourself. So
okay, for this moment, for this activity, this much time is, I think,
enough.
Next activity I will tell is, please write your goal in a line or two. Please write your goal in a line or two, or in few words.
I mean, no, last activity. To achieve this goal, whatever you have written in your diary, what you must do.
How much congruence is there between the first part, how you spend your day, and what you must do to achieve your goals? How much is the similarity? How much is the congruence between the two activities?
70 to 80%. Any other variation?
40%. Okay. So
I'm going to speak a little bit about time management. Little bit, because this is not. You can say pre-translation, because there is no such person, I'm just taking the driver's seat. So I'm going to speak a little bit about time management. So whatever words I'm going to speak, they are inspired by 3 to 4 people. First one is Brian Tracy. Second person is Jamshed Darasha sir. Third person, Stephen Covey. Okay. And fourth person is Jack Welch. So I'm just going to summarize what these people wanted to speak to you regarding time management. So don't go through the slides, it's for me, so that I can remember the points. So, a lot of studies have been done in Harvard Business School in the last 20 years. A lot of studies were done about effective people and not so effective people, successful people and not so successful people. They wanted to find out the critical success factors which makes people more efficient, makes people more successful. And one thing they find which is very common is time management. One thing which is a common factor in all these successful people is time management. These are the people who could get better jobs. These are the people who could get better salaries, who could get earlier promotions in their life. They were very well organized in their resources. So people become successful, one of the critical factors is time management. And as Dada sir has been saying from the first session, that whatever we have received in terms of good percentile, because you are cut above the class, you are in one of the top leading B schools. So I'll not spend a lot of time, because you must be doing it. As I said, 70 to 80% congruence is there in the activities, what you are doing and what you must do. So itself is a great proportion. But from the improvement point of view, I'm just taking it a little bit ahead. So a simple conclusion is successful people do the same things in a different manner. And that manner is they are much more organized. They can use the same 24 hours in much more efficient way than the unsuccessful people. So I'll just ask one or two people to read out their goals, what they have written.
just one or two people. Yes, Rutul. Yes.
So my
golden okay, and one more person. Yes.
I want to get a good job, my own house. Yes.
Okay, great, great. So I'm just going ahead. I'm just keeping some of these slides. Okay, so the first, there are a few factors in which are important for time management. First is goal. Because what are goals? Somebody was speaking first day that when we are using Google Maps, it asks you what is your present location and what will be your destination. So destination is your goal, what you want to accomplish in your life. What you want to accomplish in your life. And suppose you are driving a four-wheeler. Suppose you are driving a four-wheeler, you are in the driver's seat. You have clutch, brake, accelerator. You know very well A, B, C, accelerator, brake, and clutch. But suppose you don't have a steering wheel. Suppose you don't have a steering wheel, what will happen? Where the car will go? Really, you cannot tell where the car will go in the market. Similarly, happen with us that if we don't have clearly defined goals in our life, what you want to achieve, then you are in a driver's seat but without a steering wheel. किसी ने बोल दिया engineering करो अच्छा होता है engineering के लिए. किसी ने तो बोल दिया MBA करो MBA अच्छा है job मिला है MBA आ गए. If you are not in a driver's seat with a steering wheel, people beside you, they are going to tell you what to do and what not to do. Better you decide your goals, where you want to take your car. So goals, they are, as I said, they are the destination point. And whenever you are writing your goal, you should always write from this perspective. Whenever you are writing your goals, you should write from these perspectives. I may be contradicting with some of the resource persons who have been addressed earlier that you should think of your own first, then think about family. No. Being a human being, you cannot differentiate between professional life, personal life, family life, social life. No, you cannot have such kind of compartments for emotions. So whenever you are defining your goals, you should have a personal goal, what you want to achieve personally, what you want to achieve for your family in a materialistic manner, probably home, a car, business goal. If you are having some startup or want to have some startup in the future, what will be the business goal? What will be career goal? Have you mapped your career? People in the second year also, they are confused that whether to take marketing or HR, then how they will map their career. This is the right time. This is the right time. Think where you want to be after 5 years in your career. Try to map your career. Have some steps that after 2 years this way, I will achieve this much. After 5 years, I will achieve this much. So have career goals, self-development goals. Most important. I still remember that when I joined this organization, that is teaching fraternity, I have never taken session. It was a very terrible day, first day for me. But I took the responsibility of my development, and whatever I'm doing, I'm still progressing. But how many people have actually set a goal for self-development that Yes, if I want to work in automobile industry, most of the companies, they are German makers, German automobile makers, I should learn German. So, have you developed a link with your career goals and self-development goals? Think about it. So whenever you are writing a goal, please include all those things. Okay, because all the things, they are part and parcel of life. You cannot differentiate one thing from the another thing. And most important, in the first day also I said, that purpose is more important. Values are more important. Values should dictate the goals. She said that I don't have any materialistic goals. Value systems, guide to write something which is non-materialistic. So values play important role in goals. What are your values? I want to earn money, but how? I want to gain power, but how? Ethically, unethically, in the right way, wrong way? So values dictates the goals, and values must dictate the goals. So, second thing was, please write down your goals in black and white. Write down your goals in black and white. Again, one of the research in Harvard Business School suggests that the people who write their goals in black and white, the probability of getting success or getting on the way of success increases by 65%. Okay, probability of getting success. Gaining success increases by 60%. Have you written down your goals? Whether you can write your personal goal statement, mission statement, think about it. It is not a one-day activity. It is not a one-day activity. And this is a personal meditation, self-awareness. Madam was telling you yesterday, self-awareness. What I want to achieve in my life, for my family, for myself, in my career, for my business. And it may not happen in one day. It's a self-examination, which will probably be next agenda, self-concept and self-awareness is a different thing. But please write plan of action that what you are going to do to achieve those goals. Make a list of activities, most crucial step. I'm not going to take a lot of time, but make down a list before you begin any activity. Accordingly, most of the successful people say that plan your day in the evening. You should plan your next day in the evening, evening prior. Why? Subconsciously, in the night, your mind and brain starts to prepare for the next day, that tomorrow I'm going to plan my day in this manner. I will do these activities. These things may happen. I need to take these decisions. Somewhere your mind starts to prepare for the next day from the beginning only. So whenever you are planning your day, next day, it should start in the beginning. Because throughout the night, the brain will be working on those activities. So always make a list. Always make a list of activities which you are going to do in the next day. And whenever you are doing the list of activities, in the evening, you yourself will evaluate. This is not important. This is important. This is not important. This is important. So every activity, you should be able to relate with your goal. Whether it is congruent with my goal or not. Whether it is congruent with my goal or not, whether these activities will be helpful in achieving my goal or not. So that decision you are taking one day prior. So the research again from the behavioral science tells that when you make a list, when you are making the list only, your productivity improves by 25%. You are ahead of others by 25% whenever you are deciding in advance that these things I'm going to do tomorrow. So please, this is bold italic underlying statement that please always list down the activities, because listing downs helps in two manners. When you list down the activity and you complete certain activities, it gives you motivation, it gives you happiness, it gives satisfaction that in a checklist there were 10 activities I have completed, I am proceeding to the second. It gives a lot of happiness and that gives you motivation for the second one. So always make a list of activities a day prior. So this will be probably, this is a point where I will be spending some time before conclusion. Set priorities. What is relevant and what is not relevant. Okay, so people who have done their BBA, they must have been very well versed with this principle, Pareto principle. 80-20. You must have read this principle in your graduation, especially BCom people and BBA people, that 80-20 rule. 20% are those crucial activities which will give you 80% results. Only 20% activities will give you 80% result. And rest of the 80% activities which you do, routine activities, not so important activities, they contribute for only 20% of the performance, of the result. So that is Pareto principle, 80-20. 20% activities will contribute for 80% of the performance or 80% of the success. Rest of the 80% activities, what we do, they not contribute so significantly. So whenever you are making a list, whenever you are making a list of activities, I have made four different parts about self-development or personal growth activities, job prospectus from the job point of view, from family point of view, and friends and social relationships. Now, whatever activities you have written down in the evening, please prioritize that, which are the two most important activities, in terms of self-development I must do today. Anyhow, I will not skip these two activities. Think about it. So if it is from the job prospectus, okay, those who are having some work experience, they must be noting that today these activities are mandatory. At any cost, I have to complete it before my lunch. So from all the perspective, you have to prepare top 20 activities, because these are the activities which are going to make you successful. Rest of the 80% activities, I think they are not so important. And I have been telling that these things you just cannot avoid. Friends, social relationship, networking, it matters a lot in the success. Everybody is saying that this is 134 plus your alumni network is strong. Networking, friends, social relationships matter a lot. At any point of time, for a freshers or a person having 20 years of corporate experience, it matters equally. Relationship, at the workplace, relationship, corporate relationship, friends, because it not only helps in exchanging of the ideas, but it also helps to vent the feelings which are accumulated at the workplace, or the stress, or the things which happen at the workplace, you can share with someone. So I said okay, I may be differing with some of the resource persons earlier, but these are important things. And ineffective people, what they do, they focus on the remaining 80% activities, which are really very trivial for their success. And I said, these are the things which differentiate between successful people and unsuccessful people, is what they do, how they utilize their 24 hours. Ineffective people, they focus on those activities which are not really important. Then why they focus? They focus because of two, three reasons. First reason is it gives them happiness. It gives them happiness because they are not touching difficult issues. Okay. Sometimes trivial things give happiness. Sometimes it is a pressure of time. Aaj mail karna hi hai, meeting hai, I need to wind up these things. So activities are trivial, but there is a pressure of time. They are not important, but they are urgent. Third thing is, okay, they keep on postponing these things and they focus on these things, little tasks, irrelevant tasks, because they cannot prioritize what are the top 20% and what is below 80%. The people can prioritize, they are the successful people. So first, try to prioritize your activities, top 20%, top 80%, below 80%. And this is common for all. This is common for all. Suppose a boss is there, a boss, and he is handling a team of, suppose, 10 people. Two people are really very great. They are excellent performers. And there are 8 people. This is a hypothetical example. And 8 people, they are not so effective. They are still learning. If boss diverts his attention on remaining 80%, their development, their nourishment, their training, what will happen to the top performers? Top two people?
They will get affected because everyone is looking for that only 80% people. So maybe their efficiency will be little bit decreased.
Okay, but so
that depends on their mentality, how they react to that process.
Okay. So if boss, from the boss perspective, I will not see from the employee's perspective, if someone is spending his energy on the people who are less efficient, who are not working, who are not reporting properly, who cannot do their task properly, how he can focus on his work? His work, he must be having some targets, some assignments, and he continues to give attention on the remaining 80%, his energy will get consumed on those things only, which are not so important. So always focus on your energy on top 20%, top 20% activities. And it is common for everyone. Try to jot down probably what gives your mother more happiness. If you have one activity per day also, she'll be really very happy. What makes your mother very happy? What she expects from you in a day? Probably a good sentence or a single good deed. Even if you do that much also, I'm thinking about family and I'm speaking mother because most of us, you are single. Okay. Otherwise, the example could have been different. A single activity, single statement, will also make a lot of difference in the interpersonal relationships. So please try to prioritize what is really very important for your success and what is not really important for your success. And please always focus on top 20%. Now, whenever you are deciding about priority, you should keep these three R's in the mind. You should keep these three R's in the mind. First R.
Required.
Required. What is required of me if I'm doing a job, a lecturer? What is required of me from my job description? I must take sessions. I must take sessions on time. I must prepare for my sessions. I must deliver properly so that students can learn. As a job profile, I must do certain administrative activities, certain examination related activities. I know what is required of me. And from that perspective, in these requirements, what is top 20% and what is remaining previous 80%, that is different thing. But have you thought about you? What is your job as a student? What is required of you? What is expected from you?
To learn more.
Concentration in?
To focus on? Whatever we are learning in class.
Okay. Consistency in?
Self-preparation.
So you can list down these activities. There may be 20, 30 activities to focus, to concentrate, to learn. Okay. To prepare for the session. Then who stops us from doing these things? Okay. Nobody stops us from doing those things. Let the parents tell you, study mat bilkul karna. Nobody stops us. Those who are really think good about us, they will never stop us from doing what is required of us, because that is mandatory. And as an employee, we are paid for the first thing. What is required of me? I should give 100%, not 100%, 200% what is required. Next thing is, what is
returns?
What gives me returns? What gives me returns? The returns may be not only the material returns. Okay. Material returns nahi hai. It may be intellectual learning. What gives me returns? And last thing is,
what gives me reward?
What gives me reward? That if I continuously perform these activities over a period of time, what will give me reward? Whether I will be achieving my goal or not. So these three R's should be kept in mind. What is required of me from my job profile? Okay, what gives me returns? Not only monetary, but intellectual, social, cultural, psychological satisfaction and rewards. Okay, rewards. Not only again this, but other parts of it. If I continue to do these things for a longer period of time, what will give me rewards? On the basis of these three R's, we should prioritize the activities. Very important thing, leaders understand that activity is not necessarily an achievement. So whatever you are doing right now is an activity. Induction program kar diya, there will be 20 resource person. Ek ne aake motivation bol diya, self-awareness bol diya, time management bol diya. Unless you apply something in life, it will be just an activity. 7-day activity thi college ki. College ke liye ek active ho gayi, activity ho gayi, mere liye ek activity ho gayi. I spend my 7 days in that activity. But what is the outcome for me? What is the outcome for my development? Unless you start to learn from certain activity, it will not be an accomplishment. And that's the difference. I started because okay, to write it down, because from the first day, I've been seeing that people just listen. And there are very few people who are actually taking notes of what has been spoken by the resource person. What has been spoken by the resource person, probably you'll forget after 2, 3, 4 days, 4, 5 days, or probably after 1 month, you'll forget the name of the resource person also. So it should not remain an activity. Whatever these great people have spoken in the last 4, 5 days, how many people have written down? Not here, but actually written down. And I started that those people who write down their goals, effectiveness grows by 25%. 25%. And my boss used to say me that, because jab adivasi the na, they don't have papers, they don't have pens, they used to write. If they want to remember something, they will write on wall or on some stone, because they could memorize afterwards. But we are so developed that we have increased our memories to such an extent that we have forgotten writing. Most of the students were, okay, doing these things, chatting, especially at the middle or at the end. So this is not just an activity. Unless you take certain things from these 7 days, it will not be an achievement. I attended one personality development workshop. Whether it's an achievement, no. What I interpreted, what I applied in my life, that is more important. So I have given the contribution to Mr. Stephen Covey. I have taken this from his book only. So these are the 4 types of activities. Seniors must be aware if they have attended that session last year. Stephen Covey's 4 quadrants of time management. And he has differentiated the activities in 4 quadrants. Activities which are really urgent and important. Activities which are urgent but not so important. Not urgent but important, and both. They are not urgent also and they are not important also. Now, think the activities, the first assignment which has been given to you, how you spend your day, which are the activities you do, you are doing in a routine day, in a normal day, and in which quadrant they fall. In which quadrant they fall. Now, this is really very important. This is really very important because they are urgent also and they are important also. At the workplaces, you'll find that every morning some different work will come to you, and whatever you have decided that I will complete these activities, it will go behind. Certain urgent, certain important will come to you, and that will take the driver's seat. There are the pressing problems, deadline-driven projects, assignment. Pura 15 din mein soya tha. Kal hi last day hai to project, to show the project. That is our every year's experience, that people turn up in the last 2, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days only to show the project. Because deadline is there and you stick to deadlines. Why not earlier? But these are the activities which are deadline best, which are very important, which are timely driven. Rise. Unless you do it, there will be no things. These are they are not important but urgent. This is written from the employee's point of view. But there are interruptions, visitors, phone calls, guests. Okay, there are a lot of interruptions in the process. Reports, mails, matters, popular activities, tea breaks, and all those things will be in this activity, tea break in this activity, quadrant 4. But you have to send a mail. Not really
important, but urgent. Certain meeting is there. You know that this meeting is not going to give a lot of inputs for you. This meeting is not going to help you a lot, but still there will be meeting. You are going to attend it knowingly that there will be nothing, there will be no output. So such kind of activities which are urgent but not really important, and most of us spend a lot of time on these activities, quadrant 1 and quadrant 2. Successful people, they always focus on this quadrant only. Successful people, they focus on this quadrant only. Personal development. Personal development. That is really important from the goal orientation, goal congruence, goal achievement point of view. How I'm going to develop myself. My communication skills, my presentation skills, my grooming. How I'm going to develop myself. How I'm going to develop my capability, that is capability development. Whether I'm going to do certain advanced access course, or I'm going to do certain Python course, or I'm going to do certain digital marketing, whatever my goal is. How I'm going to build my capability. Time sabke paas 24 hours hi hai. Either you are focusing on this or this, it's entirely your decision. It's entirely your decision how you spend your time. So successful people, they focus on these things. Okay, recognizing new opportunities. What are the trends in the market? What technologies may evolve? How I can prepare myself for the new technology? Which companies are coming? What they want? What kind of people they are looking for? Whether I have it, those things in me or not? What should I do? Opportunities. Looking for opportunities. Not only looking, after identifying the opportunities, how you are going to develop the capabilities. Last thing. Okay. Last thing. Time wasters. Okay. Time wasters. Trivial mails, phone calls. Okay. Time wasters. Pleasant activity, which will not really contribute for the success. Okay. Chai ka break hota hai 15 minute ka. You take it to, you stretch it to 30 minutes. What important thing you do in the remaining 15 minutes? Just chit chat, office gossip, okay. Or gossip about faculties or gossip about other students. What it contributes to your goals? Not really. They are just time wasters. They are just time wasters. I still remember one of the examples from a salesperson in Ford. His name is one of the successful salesperson in the world, top 40 successful people. And he said that when I started my career, when there was no customers, other salespeople used to come, they have tea break, chit chat, gossip about the office. But I used to take out a directory, customer list. I used to call them, just say hello, just wanted to ask about help, just wanted to build the relationship. And it helped me. And it helped me in getting better network than others. I was inch ahead than others. Rather than spending time in gossiping, I always focus on those activities which will help my customers whenever they needed me. So think about it, how you are going to spend your time. And this is a core of entire time management gimmick. Whether you are going to focus on these things in these 2 years, or chai ka katta, Instagram, Facebook, just writing assignments without knowing what you are writing, how you are going to do it? You are just complying to the things, compliance to these
whatever faculties have given as an assignment, or you are going to take the responsibility that yes, this project is going to help me in this manner, and that's why I'm doing it. You are doing the same thing, but the perspective is different. But the perspective is different. How you are going to do it? This is the same thing. This is the same thing in different manner. First thing was urgent and important. They always give you stress. They always give you stress. These you should focus upon. In that thing, I have mentioned one person is exercising. Very important. Very important. Exercise. Spending time for your health. It is capability building. One more thing in all the successful managers is the good health, sound health. So yes, spending time on your health is important. Relationship building with your colleagues, ex-colleagues, classmates, planning for the future, self-developments, continuous learning by certification, reading, referring reports, time wasters. The itself is like Facebook, Insta, YouTube, where you spend a lot of time. I'm not saying you, a generation. Please. I should stop WhatsApp. It's up to you. Huh? Can you read? This little bit loud.
Yes, sir. Choose or lose, either you choose your priorities or you will lose your priorities to somebody else that will choose them for you.
Remember that you have to choose your priority. Okay. You have to choose your priorities, otherwise someone else will choose for you. If you cannot decide what is good for you, there are always people who will tell you that do this, do that. And you are giving the control of your life in someone else's life, in someone else's hand. Who are someone else who is going to decide what should be your priority? What you are going to do in a day, who should decide it? It should be you. So you are responsible for everything, whatever happens in life. It is you who take the decision. It is you how you spend your time, whether on quadrant 1 or quadrant 3 or quadrant 2 or quadrant 1. You set your priorities. If you are not capable enough, your parents will take. Your friends will take the decisions about your priorities. So think about the sentence. This is ABCDE. Okay. This is ABCDE. Okay, this is the last slide. How to set the priorities. You have prepared a list of activities. How to sort out the activities, which are important activities and which are not so important activities, is this. You should start from E stands for eliminate. E stands for eliminate. Looking at the goals, if you have listed down the activities, think that even if I don't do these things, it will not affect my life at all. Personal life, family life, nothing. These are just trivial activities. Eliminate those activities. Don't do those activities which are really not important in your life. D stands for delegate. It may be probably more appropriate for the working executives, not at this point of time where you are responsible to do everything of on your own. You cannot delegate at this stage. But whenever you start working, please think that these are the activities, even if I delegate to my junior, they will not make a lot of difference. And I trust him that he can do it. He can do it properly. And whenever he is doing properly, please give credit to him also. But the things which really are not crucial, you can always delegate it. We are thinking from the time management perspective. See, things it would be nice to do. Okay. It would be nice to do if you have completed A and B. If you have completed A and B, then only think about C. If your top 20% is over, then think of next things. Otherwise, be focused on A and B, top two important things. 20% will give you 80% results. If your that top 20% is over, focus on things. Okay. Focus on C. That it will be nice to do. Karega, nahi karega, zyada matter nahi karta hai. But A and B, you must do and you should do. You must do. A is you have to do at any cost. That should be your focus. That should be the focal point of all the activities. You should complete that task. You must do. Those are A activities, and B is you should do. It is not must, but you should do. So these are the things, A, B, C, D, how you can shortlist whether the activity is really important or not really important. And people procrastinate, that is, people postpone the activities. People postpone the activities. So there may be a question that because of I was so heavily loaded today that I postponed some activities. Don't do it, especially in case of A and B. You must do the things you must do and the things you should do. Don't postpone those activities. You should be able to define what should be postponed, what should not be postponed. Yes. If he is saying that, let's go to a movie. Today is Friday, first day, first show. You are saying, even if I see it tomorrow, day after tomorrow, on Monday, whether it will be making any difference, movie will be same, actor and actresses are going to be same. But if I postpone very important activity, which is crucial for my success, it will matter. So you should be able to differentiate. Postpone karna, but what to postpone and what not to postpone, you should be able to decide. I think I have given a lot of gain. I should wonder. It's not visible. Can you read? A, B, C, D, E. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
First one is you make a list of all the things you like you to accomplish in the next 1 to 5 years, and then you go down the list goals and prioritize them as like 1, 2, 3 or ABC.
Okay. So please plan your goals for the next 5 years. In next 5 years, I want to be like this. This I want to do for myself, for my personal development, for my career development, for my capability development, for my family, for material gains. Probably I would like to purchase a car or a scooter or a home. Whatever your goals may be, these are the next 5 years. Then you prioritize them as number one, number two, number three. Next.
Second step is then take those A goals, which are listed as, you transfer them to another sheet, make a list of all the things you are going to have to do to accomplish your goals.
So now think of just three goals, goal number A, B and C. Now you have taken the most important goal for your life, goal number A. Now list down all the important activities, okay, which will be helpful in gaining success to achieve goal number one. Please done all the activities, all the list you have to prepare for goal number one.
First step is prioritize like A, B, C, the list, the end, what are the things you must do, what are the things I should do, and the things that would be nice to do to accomplish the goals.
Okay, so once you have decided that this is my goal number one, this is the list of activities, now prioritize A, B, C, D, E. These are the activities I must do, I should do, it will be nice to do. This things I'm going to delegate, and this things I'm going to eliminate, so that I'll be focused on top 20%. Last step.
Next step is in another sheet, write the activities like ABC for accomplishment of the goals, and then you structure and schedule.
Okay, then you structure and schedule. So this is a very systematic process. The things really do not happen in this manner, but yes, as I said, in world there are 5% to 7% successful people, and they have utilized their time in a better manner, and they have structured their day in such a manner that they could prioritize what is helpful for me and what is not helpful for me. Two laws of time are there. Okay, first law is, it's like time is like air. It will spread to the volume. Balloon mein kitna hawa hai? Balloon khulta jayega. Similarly, if you don't give deadlines to those activities, you will continue to spend your time on those activities. And time contracts also. So, if you want to do an activity, suppose I give you that tomorrow I want this assignment to be done at any cost, most of the people will submit it. Most of the people will submit it. But I give you 8 days deadline. How many people will submit it tomorrow? No one, because it's a mentality. It's the mentality that we are deadline-based. And time generally expands us in time contracts us. How much we are going to utilize of the time is our responsibility. Thank you. With this note, please.
I think we had a wonderful session from Dr. Vikas Dole on the time management. And I'm quite sure that for the last 5 days that we have been seeing so many things and we've been learning so many wonderful concepts that were being shared by the expert speakers. Today we end the day with another session that was on time management. And I'm sure that you all will implement this in your journey that you all are beginning from now on. I would like to thank Dr. Vikas Dole for conducting the session. Thank you very much, sir. I would request Professor Damshit to felicitate Dr. Vikas Dole. Thank you very much. We close for today.
Thank you.